Let's continue Rogue Legacy 2. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Have you been enjoying so far? Don't think I can buy anything. Okay. I have a lot of silver. I mean, that's the next tier up, so... Apparently this does more. I need to save for that. Resolve room for sure. Alright, so another gold gathering thing immediately. Yesterday went really well. Whole new area, but I'm gonna do the same strategy as last time, which is like earn some health and some stuff and then go. I think that's the best way to do it, to be honest. Useful. I don't care, I want the gold. All right, no iframes. Wait, is this impossible for me to recover from? Okay, hang on. Assuming it doesn't just put me in the same spot again. Okay, that's fine. It's a bailout, but that was a soft lock. The inability to recover. All right, we're back to normal now. it bailed me out. Scales with it, alright. Could have been worse. I think this time around I'll get weapons. I'll spend money on weapons wherever I can. Get the next tier. I think the no iframe thing is just, I can't fight the boss, clearly. But I might be able to do the room before the boss. Resolve. No, thank you. Too much resolve. I mean, yeah, it's just because resolve is too low. Spell is thunder. Are they gonna get closer? I don't know, they will. Yeah, that's a huge advantage. Gain 50 resolve. Just have to not die. Should be okay. It'll even out. Expected worse though. Alright, onwards. I just need 6 more enemies. Thank you. Okay, 5. Ooh. Three more. Two more. One more. Done. Okay, we're safe now with extra resolve. Oh, that wasn't too bad. One's always pretty straightforward. Shit. I know the no iframe thing is like pretty annoying, but I do this for the extra gold. Extra gold. Oops. Ah, damn it. Bad spot. think with the armor purchases, I should be able to make more progress. We'll see. Interesting. I mean, still above max resolve, so we're fine. That seems to be doing a lot. Ooh, this is annoying. There we go. That was a little rough. Love how a book gave me food, but then something I destroyed that looked like I had food gave me nothing. As much as the other one intrigues me, it's gonna lower my resolve too much. I'm gonna try to aim for about 15,000 gold. That'll let me purchase whatever new armor I got. That would be weird though. I do like that it gives you the option to do weird stuff like that. Oh, this is death. There we go. Yeah. The zero iframe thing. Already up to 10,000. Oh, geez. There's nothing down there. See what this is. Oh. That's actually useful for what's going on right now. Oh, it's spin kicks, never mind. I thought it was immunity to ground. Immunity to ground traps, that would be so good. Then the iframe thing wouldn't matter. I wouldn't be able to soft lock myself. Go back to the entry. I'm not gonna get it. This what end up ability. If I had an attack that went off quicker, I probably would have gotten it. Maybe I could have used Stormcloud. Is that it? Guess. Oh, no, wait, no. I was gonna say, that's very brief. Really? Okay. That's a bit unlucky. Same thing twice. There's nothing up there. Yeah, it's fine. I have no iframes, so that's probably not going to be very useful. Bonus damage on the ground. 21 resolve. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I have to jump a lot. I think that goes well with that ability where you can put ground at your feet if you're an archer. Closer to go back to the entry. One more room. But money gathering success so far. Ow, it's just this. Next. What have I even got? Okay. It's just curious because it's like, I guess that's what it was the kick just not being the kick anymore. Jeez. I don't think I'm gonna be ballsy enough to go to the next area to get money. I think I'll just head straight to the area I haven't done. Beat all enemies. Oh wait. Well, we'll switch first. Where's the switch? Increases the duration of status effects. Ooh. That's like just straight up damage increase for mage and chef. Why do I keep getting food from books? Oh crap. No recovery frames, so that makes it so annoying. It's alright, I'm fine. Chicken. failing mate. Opening chests restores health, intelligence. 10% of your damage absorbed. That seems insane. Getting my damage absorbed by mana. Not all of it, but... I mean, it's a cost, I just have to hit, and then it's back. Chicken. Oh, right. Mimics. Okay. Nice. Gain additional double jumps. Suppose there is a benefit for me to go to the other area. Oops. Oh yeah, there it was. Ooh, that's annoying. I think I have enough of the armor that I want to buy. So even if I don't succeed in progressing further, at least I'll get a bunch of stuff. I think that's it, right? Oh no, wait, there's more. I just have to assume the chest is bad. Ah. Still debating. I should try, because I could get items out of it. What's that? Gain flight and damage immunity. Comet form. A talent, so it'd be replacing Thunderstorm. I'll try it. Okay, that could get me out of some trouble. Honestly, not bad. It does damage too, so that's cool. So this is one such room where it came in handy. Death beam. Stop. If it wasn't for this iframe thing, this would be a very good build. That's the only downside to what's going on right now. Keep increasing health, I'll recover it somehow. Gotta hope for more food. Hey. Alright, that pretty much does it. Why not? I'll do what I can. Oh, well, okay. I'm gonna stick to the indoors part. I'm gonna look for where the purple markings are as well. That's outdoors. Okay. Straightforward. That is annoying. Okay, there we go. Oh, this is so useful for this part. Laser. That thing's name was McRib. Oh no. Blocks up to 2 attacks, consumes 150 mana per block. Nah. I think I'm good. I honestly doing pretty well. This ability is so good. Didn't click, I can use this to bail me out of the platforming. Like, just wait for cooldown. This. This ability is so good. There is one downside to it. It's like I don't have an offensive ability, but I think it makes up for it in the fact that I can just get through areas that would otherwise be a pain in the ass. I don't think there's anything else over there. There's no icon. Once again, wait for the cooldown, I'll get the right. I love this. Food. Need a heal. Jeez, I have 40,000 gold. Oh, what have I done? That was bad. Alright, that's fine. Need these things to follow me down. There we go. Oh no. If that's the room I think it is, I should take the heal. Well, that changed things. Crit chance for spells increased. I'll take it. Because crits heal. And that's not that much loss of a health. This is so good. Okay, now we're looking much better. Lose no health. I mean, I should probably check that room as well. Oh man, love it. Days since rebellion. Foolish man is nothing. With nothing to learn. Okay. No, that's fine. Nice fake wall. Hammer. Dash attacks always crit. Slowed while moving. I'm good. should have gone into invulnerability form. The sun is up, thank you for that. I mean, I've almost completely explored this. As crazy as that might sound. Down and to the left, and that's it. Okay, that's it, right? I can't believe that. I did the tower. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Onwards. Down that way. Nothing to be afraid of. Shit. they're not worth it. Shield. No, I'm good. Death Beam is better. Probably not. Towards suspending. Oh shit, that was bad. I was just on the edge of that. Jeez. Okay. Whatever. Say okay. Keeping me chained here. Oh shit. Ugh. Didn't realize it was a zombie. Ah, oh, it appeared underneath me. Damn it. Fair attempt. Okay, but like, the important thing here is the money. Yeah. Okay, so hold on. Exit skill tree. Okay. Present weapon. That's fine. I'll just buy what I can here and then go back and upgrade. Increases mana capacity. Yeah. That'll go well with this character. Okay, now... this might allow me to equip stuff now. Resolve amount. Help. Damn, what is the one with gold? Let's see. Hey, I can equip it now. This IBS doesn't do anything bad, it's just like, haha, farting sound. Alright. So again, I'm just gonna try and get as much money as I can and then go for progression once that's done. I'll see what this is. For shits and giggles, what is it? After being hit, deal 100% more damage. Oh wow, that's good. Especially since with the chef I spam melee attack. If I can find the one that increases the iframe duration, that'll go really well. Blessing of talent, no thanks. Never gonna replace talent. Spell, maybe. I'm honestly surprised I survived as long as I did with the other character. Your weapon applies extended burn. Alright, well that's just a chef skill right there. I'll take the loss in health. It'll come in handy later when enemies are more tanky, or if I get up to the boss. It's gonna be pretty invaluable. Deals increased damage to things that have burn on them. Oof. Okay, there's like room to the right. Go from here. Swing works. Nah, we're good. Damn it. Hey, Nick, how's it going, man? How's things? Feels good to have iframes back. Okay, go down. I got to cool down a bit. Nice. Here it hasn't warmed up. It's just miserable outside. What is... Oh, I see. That's fine. At this point, it doesn't do much damage, so we're fine. I want the money. Got much on this weekend. Just done nothing but housework, pretty much. I think I'm getting to the point where, like, I assume I'm near the end, because there's one more portrait to go. Not much this weekend, yeah. Same. Just been catching up on games that I kind of left behind when Tears of the Kingdom came out, so this is one of them. misjudged that. Upgrades. Oh my god. Stop. I need to kick off. It keeps destroying the projectile. I need to kick off it. Maybe not. Hang on. How is this done? At this point, this has stopped being worth it. I'm gonna lose so much health just by trying to get that. I thought you were supposed to kick jump off those. It's just one chest, so it won't make that much of a difference. Yeah, look, see, I did it there. Like, just incapable of doing it. That's what I needed to do in the previous room. And I just did it instantly there. Maybe I'm just not doing the input quick enough. Screw it, I'm gonna lose health. I think it's just too awkward. It shoots too quickly. There's no help. Good thing my arm is good. So far this has been pretty unlucky. I haven't gotten any challenge rooms or anything like that. Just fairy chests, which, eh. It's just giving me blood, which, sure. I think I was just too slow for it. Whoops. This game kind of makes me miss Dead Cells to some extent. think the problem with Dead Cell is like I've I came to the acceptance that I just don't think I'll ever finish anything beyond the first difficulty. It just becomes too hard. But otherwise I did enjoy that game. I can always just swap to the base difficulty. I mean, but I don't, by doing that, like, I wouldn't be able to earn most things, right? Like, it would cap at what I'd be able to get from it. Or is it I can earn everything with the base difficulty? Because if that's the case, that's more worthwhile. I think realistically I could get through the second difficulty after hitting my head against a brick wall, but beyond that, I don't think there's a feasible way for me to do that. It's just beyond my skill level. Especially since shields got nerfed, so that was the way I ended up beating it the first time. Yeah, we want that. It's a good replacement. Keep thinking it's the purple one that you can dash through and it boosts you. What game am I talking about? Dead Cells. Cool game. Combat is very fluid, but it gets really difficult. From a quicksand, there's about 15 items locked behind. Higher or highest? Because I don't think I can go to the highest difficulty. But okay, I mean that's more in higher. Okay. Yeah. We'll see. What the heck is that? White Star. Gain the blessing of wisdom. Explosions now neither friend or foe. Can damage yourself. Will always skill crit. Oh. Nah, screw that. Screw that. To be fair, Dead Cells required practice from what you remember. I quit it quite fast. Because the problem was I purchased the Switch version, which back then was ideally a good idea, but the problem was it had micro stutter. You remember the micro stutter? How that would get me killed? Like, just randomly, it'd be like, oh cool. There was half a second of lag. So when it comes to anything precision, you don't want that. And then other stuff just came out. I don't think I rage quit it at all. It was just, yeah, I have to stop playing it. I beat the first difficulty and was like, all right, I'm good for a while. And then just never went back for it. Yeah, the Switch version, I don't know if they fixed it, but it made... That was like, I think, the start of me going, I need to stop purchasing the Switch versions of games. That was definitely the start of that. And then, yeah, my Pro Controller started getting drift issues. It was just like a whole headache of things. So if I was to try it again, I would pony up and get the PS5 version, in all honesty. And I can stream it at 1440p. Although maybe I could run 1440p on PC. Like, I'm sure I could do it, provided the game's not that graphic intense. My computer's definitely due for an upgrade. It'll probably happen in the next year or so. Just get it on PC. Yeah, I mean... Here's the thing. If I'm playing on PC, I would love to use the DualShock controller. But the problem is, a lot of games on PC, they don't 100%... You can use the controller, but then on screen, Xbox buttons appear, and it just does my head in. So unless it's been made for DualShock 5 compatibility, and I can use that controller on PC, it just gets annoying. That's a good one, but I feel like it's going to shrink my health too much. You don't mind that you don't see the PlayStation buttons? I do. That's just me. It's a me thing. I know. I do have an Xbox controller, but I'd be playing that game with a D-pad, and I just hate the D-pad on the Xbox controller. It's one of those things that they try to be fancy with its design in terms of visual look. It's just... Stop reinventing the wheel. The D-pad was great with the Super Nintendo controller, like, just... Or the PlayStation controller. Just do that D-pad, make the D-pad good. Otherwise, the Xbox controller is good. I like it. It's just... The D-pad is its biggest letdown. Anyway. I like, using 1440p. So wherever I play a game going forward, where possible, I would want to play it on the PS5, just to get that quality. You know what? I think Dead Cells is free on PlayStation Plus. I don't think I even need to buy it. I'm pretty sure it is. Because I remember, like, that and Celeste were on it. Now that I think about it, I don't think I even need to buy it. I think it's just install it. I I might be wrong, but I don't know. Vague memory that it's on there. We'll have to have a look. You've been using 4K since you got your new monitor. It's nice. Yeah. It is, isn't it? So, no, Like a Dragon and Final Fantasy 16, I've been playing at 1440p, and it just looks so much better. Even if you don't, you're not watching it on a 4K screen. Like, if you're watching it on mobile, it just looks cleaner. And if you're watching it on a HD screen, it just, it looks so much better. Oh yeah, and Isaac to some extent. Yeah, towards the end of the year, I'll start looking at computer upgrade. Like, I want to do 1440p. If I'm playing PC or the PS5, that's the goal. With the Switch, it's just like, there's no point. Or the retro consoles, because it's just like, I'm gonna run them at their native resolution because it looks better. Randomize, deal damage. No, thank you. I'm good. Need one that increases resolve. Isaac's become one of those things that I'm not sure if I'm gonna finish it, to be honest. As much as I really want to, it's just some of the tainted characters, I don't think they're enjoyable. I'm not talking about tainted loss, like that one, at least I can see a scenario where I could do it. That's not the one I'm talking about, it's more the ones that are Tainted Eden is just a headache. That's, I feel like, the one that I just don't want to play. Yeah, I want to pick up something once I'm considered done with that game. Just haven't quite decided what yet. You treated Tainted Eden as Tainted Lord, just don't get hit. I suppose the frustration kind of comes from Tainted Loss, when you get hit, you lose and it's over. It's like, okay. No sense crying over spilt milk, but with Tainted Eden, the run continues, and it's just like, it's just this, it's this thing where once you get hit, that's basically it. It's like, it just keeps getting worse and worse every time you get hit. It's not even the nature of, like, it's making random and you can get something good again. It's just, I found my health kept decreasing, it just kept getting worse and worse. There was no, like, oh, maybe you might get re-rolled into something good again. Like, everything just got objectively worse. Did I beat Hades? Story, yes. Everything, no. At some point, I'll play that game once I've forgotten most of it. Maybe closer to when 2 comes out. Oh, come on, I was spamming it. There's 2 endings, I know. Like I said, beat the story. Dude, I sunk like 200 hours plus into that game, if not more. When I say I beat things, it's like, I, within reason, beat them, unless you're talking about the content that only, like, less than 1% of the player base does, then yeah, I'm generally good with that stuff. Hades is great. I like it. Just, at a certain point, other games came out and I just went to play them instead. And figure that I'll revisit it at some point properly. It's just the curse of any game that I get in early access. That's the problem, is I stop playing it sooner than I should. The curse of the early access game. Early access look rough. I mean, it's early access. Of course it will. It was fun, though. If I can find something that gives me resolve, then this build is going to be great. But otherwise, it's like just money-making exercise. That's all this is going to be. Why is health lower? This game has a system called resolve. So, when you pick up an artifact, something that makes you stronger, it costs a certain amount of resolve. So when your resolve is above 100%, you don't lose health, but then as your resolve drops below 100%, the cost of health it takes on you, it's like exponential. So right now, I grab this thing that lets me do AoE damage on hit, but it dropped my resolve to 45%. That number next to the level 149. I can gain it by getting another item, but for now, like, that's what it's gonna be. There's also things you can pick up to increase your health, which I just did there. It's like, take damage, but increase your health. Just kind of been unlucky. I haven't really found many of them. The pink area, the final area. Nope. I'm just grinding old areas for money so then I can get upgrades and have a better chance at surviving the area that I'm up to. Thank you. So I do a lap of the map and then go to where I'm supposed to be. Because I found if you just go there straight away, you're just on the back foot. I mean, the area colors don't really matter. It's just to identify a biome, more or less. You fight a boss. Every biome has a major boss in it. Once you take down the major boss, you don't fight it again. Much like Castlevania, once the boss is dead, it's just dead. But the bosses are very difficult. I would hate to have to repeat those bosses. How many biomes? I don't know. I haven't played this to, like, its fullest. Wouldn't be able to answer that. I don't look up everything about the game in advance. This is annoying. Don't know if I've beaten it or not. Honest, yeah, fair enough. I mean, most of the games I play, it's stuff that I haven't played before. With the exception of a retro game. Generally speaking, when I finish a game, I move on. I don't really linger on it. Especially if it's something that's like a 1,000-hour experience or something like that. I just look like I'm very far. I am a decent amount into it, but I don't know how to quantify how far I'm into it. Because I'm not sure. I'll support my finger on it at least 2/3 of the way. But again, no idea. Oh. Stupid mimics. To the right. I think 300 health is fine, given the extra damage that I'm doing. What the hell was that? No, thank you. No, thank you. Okay. Health increase. There we go. That's a bit more respectable. This is, I think, my favorite class. Just the tennis racket mechanics. Plus the burn damage and the heal, it's so good. There's usually a heal in this room. Guess not this time. Okay, made it to the top. There's probably like, oh no wait, there's a pocket over there. Oh shit. Oh shit. Down, down, down. Okay. Lose no health. But this one's fine because I can just... Okay. Nice. Increase... Oh, that's a good one. Armor's invaluable. I just need to increase my white class so I can equip it. Is there any point here? No. This is just the activation room. Fully healed. Cannon. That would turn me into a ranged class, but I'm always afraid of taking weapon alternatives because some of these I've just had ruin the run. I think most of them, I don't know, they're like either situational or maybe just too much of a double-edged sword compared to the basic weapons. Fun. Just when I get up to a boss, it just sucks. It just doesn't work. That's it, right? Probably just easier to go out this way. Alright. Sun Tower next. I don't know if I'll do all of the Sun Tower. I guess it depends how much damage stuff does to me here now. Yeah, I should probably go to the area that I'm doing then, if that's the case. I'll explore a little bit, but once it gets to the climbing challenges, I'll probably bail. That's all I'm gonna get to do out of it. It's a climb now. That's unfortunate. Alright. Oh. Oh, this is just a lore room. Doesn't do anything. Alright. Oh, this is the area I'm up to. There's one. All right, go to the right. Whoa. Well, okay, it's directly above me. storeroom. Okay, I've been in the storeroom before. Do it again. Okay. Wait, it's not this way? Oh shit, jeez. What? Oh, that thing has like a big arc. Ooh, shit, the void. See if I can lure it. Haha! Alright, there we go. That works. Oh, this is probably not worth it. This is not worth it. Oh shit. Ah, damn it. Well. Okay. For 35% extra gold. I haven't really played Assassins. Wait a minute. Last attack reduces cooldowns. All spells and talents have a cooldown. Does that mean Thorn Shield is just a cooldown? I think this works. Alright, I need to increase white class. It's getting really expensive. Alright. Now I can equip the heavier stuff. Oh, rune weight systems. Shit, rune weight is like different. But it did increase it a little. I need to get that one. That's probably the most important one. Oh no. Okay, it didn't work the way I thought it did. I thought it replaced mana with cooldowns, but it doesn't. So it's like, it still costs the mana it costs, but then it has a cooldown. Which, yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, I guess it's just a negative thing for gold. Fine. We'll see. I haven't played much of this class. This will probably just be a gold run. Gonna watch this and think that, oh, all the characters fought. I'll do it after this turn. It just occurred to me how I can play this as well. Oh. Yeah, no, I'll definitely do it after this turn now. But I could go just progress a little bit in the map, and then when I feel like I'm on low health, just come back up. And then just kill basic stuff to heal and rinse and repeat. Although, I guess I can't climb back up here. I'd have to find a new waypoint. Alright, too late now. Okay, so this is the actual gate. I'll go for the closest one. Jeez, this class feels kind of weak. Probably because I haven't played it much in a slow level. I'm not gonna get very far. What the hell? Yeah, that was a bad idea. But then again, it's on my weakest. It's like only rank 2. Breaking things restores mana. Defeat 6 enemies to prevent the next source of damage. Ah, oh, that's got White Star. White Star sucks. But I'll play. The mage has kind of grown on me a little. Can I even buy anything? Nah. Sure. Alright, I purchased that at least. This high jumping thing. Oh, that was quick. I have to replace that spell as quick as I can. That's just gonna get me killed. I mean, cool, it does a lot of damage, but it hurts me as well. Okay. Give health, thank you. Gain mana when hurt. With the ability to overcharge him. I mean, if I can spam lightning, it's good. Yeah, okay. For a mage, that's pretty legit. If I get a decent spell that doesn't damage me, then I think it's as potent. Damn it. It's hard. Weird room. Alright, finally got one of these. Okay, this combination's pretty legit. So, increase health. Randomize your weapon, spell, and talent. Nope. Voltaic circlet. I'll find out what it is. Hitting an enemy with your weapon generates an aura around you for 1.5 seconds. Whatever that means. Guess we'll find out. Oh, okay. That's cool. For melee, that'd be pretty legit. I don't know about this character. I guess if there's... there's a melee weapon, I could opt to take it. Hard to aim that thing. I really want to get rid of it. Pressing it a second time doesn't let you detonate it early. Okay, I'm not going to that area. I'm gonna see what else I can make my build. It's the best way to play it. Oh, it procs off mines as well. That was fine. Health increase. This is looking good. Apply mana leech for 2 seconds. No. Every 5 seconds, your next attack deals. Nah, we're good. Not worth reducing my health for any of those two. But the health increase is nice. Very healthy. What a weird room. Okay. There's another room above me. Shit. That's actually very good. Alright, for twin of these. Low health pool. But it's a damage offset, so we'll see. I should be able to get my health back up to 300 at least, and that's perfectly fine. And maybe I might get lucky and find something that increases resolve. But I think it's a gamble worth taking for the mage. I didn't see how much it blocked. Alright, I mean, that's not too bad of a reduction. Okay, back up to 300 health. It synergizes pretty well because when I take damage, I gain mana. And then that mana is used to reduce my damage, so it's good. It works really well. This is one part where the high jump sucks. When you have to do precise stuff like that. No jumping. don't know how you do that. I hate the no jumping ones. I think you have to somehow open the door without destroying the crates. Dynamite. It's a talent. Though, probably useful, I think I'd rather stick to Thunderstorm. Thunderstorm just has way more utility. So if anything's directly above you, it's so good. Alright, that's no longer a concern. Stupid high jump thing. No. If it was a melee weapon, I would have considered it. Like, having an energy shield around you as a melee character would be awesome. Straightforward. Okay. I'll have to look at rune carry weight and see if I can increase it somehow. That'll probably be the next set of purchase that I do. Health is looking better. I wouldn't say it's amazing. Oh geez, that destroys it. I still got high jumps, so it should be okay. Thunder! I would have so much health if I didn't take my resolve. Oh. There we go. Got it. I mean, getting 100 mana just for taking damage is pretty broken. And then having that sort of protect you as well. These are all the, yeah. Oh. That was quick. Go back. There's more rooms. Gotten much more luckier with the health rooms this time around. That item's interesting. I feel like there's a build you could do with flight, you just have to be careful. More careful than what I'm being. Nice. Again, the luck. Wasn't too bad. Yeah, no, we're fine. I don't have enough resolve to take that stuff. But the health is nice. Oh, wow. This is gonna make up for the health deficit. That was an elite one. Again. It's getting closer to 400. Oh my god. But it doesn't stack, it's like... Each one blocks 30% of the damage you take. So it's like, if we have two of them, it does that twice. So this doesn't make it 90%. It would be crazy if it did. It would lower my health way too much. We're done here. There's a room directly above. Okay, there's more. But otherwise, very good area so far. Yeah, there's still rooms to do. Hey, Messiah, how's it going? How's work? Just got back from it, tired. Yeah, understandable. You gonna sleep? I would imagine. Alright, if nothing else, I'm gonna get upgrades from the money I've made, so... to calm down first, that's fair. Well, I'm gonna probably play Animal Crossing after this, so it's like... something to relax to. No jumping. Jeez, that is so specific. Okay, I got it. Alright, we're done for this area, right? One more room. I want to make the most out of it. Shit. Opening chest restores health, but I'm gonna lose half of my health. No, thank you. Chests aren't that common. Okay, next area. Did you end up getting your nuggies? I went to a burger place that, whilst they're not nuggies, I forget what they call them, but they're like chicken bites, so they take a piece of breast meat and then they cut it up so it's like nugget shaped, and then they fry that stuff in olive oil, so it's like, not healthy, but it's like, oh, it's pretty good. Then you just get like a dipping sauce with it. I guess homemade chicken nuggets is the best way to put it now that I think about it. Oh, this room is horrible. Damn it. Whoa. Oh, that's annoying. I want the money. Can I get a hit? I guess if I take one hit. Or I'm just like super good at the double jump. Alright, just take the damage, it's fine. Jeez, this area is giving me grief. Food, please. Damn it. Feel better now. Less dire. Oh boy, not good. The mage character's kind of grown on me a bit. I guess because it just felt weak initially because I just didn't have anything for it. There's still a bit to explore here. Then after this, I'll go to the area that I'm up to and hope for the best. Wait, I missed the target, apparently? Well, no, just didn't explode in time. Aha. That's a shame. Oh, what fresh hell is this? Jeez. Okay. Again! It's giving me all these items, but I can't take them. They're just gonna lower my health way too much. Alright, health increase. My health is 420 now. Meme number achieved. I gotta win now. Careful with that explosion, it's actually pretty good. Shit. Oh no, chest. Oh boy. It's not looking good. Please give meat, chicken. Okay. Okay, I feel better now. Whoops. Yes. Exactly that. Just consume chicken to heal. Okay, there's like one more room. And I got the feeling it's just the way to the teleporter. Oh, maybe not. Mimic! Go away. Jeez. Owner. Okay. Just careful. I'm not gonna risk getting that. There's a painting in there as well. Oh, wow, nice. Nice, nice, nice. I can increase my health more, provided I'm successful. So many landmines. Ah! Okay, I mean, could have been worse. Shit, it's not over yet. Oh. Alright. I'm risking my life by doing this. When below 50%, deal more spell and weapon damage, but it's gonna cut my health in half, that's the problem. Otherwise this would probably be ideal. I've been getting good choices, just I've already made my choices to the point of if I pick up anything else, it's going to just make my health like 100 health, and then I'm just going to die in one hit. Collect one food portion to purify this relic and gain 64 max health and 50 mana. But if I take damage, I'm dead. Okay, let's... What I'm gonna do... I'm gonna look at the odds of this. I'm gonna look at the next few rooms. If there's a lot of breakables in the room... What the hell is this? This is nothing. If I was gonna say if there were a lot of breakables in the room, then I'll take it and gamble it. Oh yeah, no, that's it. Okay, don't take it. It's too risky. There's no more rooms that have food. Alright. I guess I have no... Wait a minute. Forgot about the sun tower. I'll take it. All I have to do is just find one piece of food. And if I go to the sun tower, there's a high chance it's in the first room. Come on. Wow. It's not. Okay, well, so if I take one hit, I'm gonna die, which is probably the case anyway. That was so close. Oh, you bastard, I got it. Alright. Alright. I'm okay. Wow. That was lucky. Alright, I'm going to where I'm supposed to be now. Jeez. Okay, wish me luck. There's one right next to me. Oh wow, okay. So this is the main room. That is really convenient. There's one to the... two to the right. Okay. So scary, this area. Doesn't reach. I'm getting rid of these. These are a disaster waiting to happen. I'm hoping it's in this direction. It's a dead end. There's probably heals in that room. Wasn't. I need to get rid of that shield. Careful. Okay. Is this... no, this is not where I need to go. There's one more to the right. I'm gonna have a look. I feel like at this point this would be too hard to fight that one. Like, I probably should. But I just get the feeling it'll be the end of the run if I do. If I had more health, I'd go for it. Did I hit? So stressful. Oh, that's the other lock. I found the other lock. Okay. I just need to find the key now. This is the big dragon. Child, a thousand greetings to you. Too many cycles has it been since one has dared venture down here. Those who came before saw to the one named Tubal. Why do you seek this vile man? He is not worthy of your remembrance. Curious as to where you are not, nor mortal entirely. Your allegiance, to whom do you serve? No matter, the covenant is the same. Free me from these shackles and I shall reveal Tubal's location. I just need to find the key. Okay, I mean, it could either be really lucky and it's one of these two, or I get really unlucky and I have to go. Oh, but I've got the teleport. Okay. So I should head back the way I came, unless there's something. I'll check these rooms, just see what's in there. If it's something worthwhile, I'll go for it. Kind of lucked out with the map. Okay, I just want to see what I'm looking at here. Like, what's the quickest way to get to that spot that I'm trying to get to? This is annoying. I need to make sure it's safe. There's one to the side. Which I guess I have to go down. There's one in this next room. Scratch that. Next room. Jeez. They have to play really well. This is the sore room. I'll get some health here. Okay, I feel a little better now. So it's either gonna be in that room over here, or I have to journey really far away and it's gonna suck. Okay, hang on. Let's do that. Really annoying. That's it. This is it. Oh, this is annoying. Alright, whatever. That was a bit of a brute force. Yikes. Oh my god. They reduced my health to 35. Fuck. Okay, if I get sneezed on, I die. I just have to make it back to that room in one piece. What the hell is this? Oh. Okay. Lower path. I'm clenching a little here. Okay. There we go. Problem. I need to do a boss fight. But I don't have the health. I think I'm gonna have to go gamble it and go teleport to another spot. I can't risk it in this area. Okay, let's go Sun Tower. Have I got any rooms that I just left behind? But oh no, I do. Okay, hold on. I left the room behind by accident. I have to heal somehow. Ah, yes. Yes. Okay. Even if that's all the healing I get, like, at least I'm not a one-shot. I just have to hope for some more chicken. Wow, there's like a whole section here I left behind, which honestly, blessing in disguise. Come on, chicken. Gonna have to risk it and go to the Sun Tower and just see what I can get from a heal perspective. The Sun Tower, it's like, as long as I don't mess up climbing it, I might be able to get some heals out of it. We'll see. At the very least, the thing is permanently unlocked now, so that's good. Let's have to play carefully. Yes! Okay, very good. It's okay. If I can turn... This is already huge. Like, I have the majority of my health back. I'm gonna do this, because this will probably get the rest of the health back. And even if it doesn't, I can opt to heal. Oh shit. Jeez. Heal. Okay. I mean... I think it kind of came out as about even. I might have a little more health. I messed up. I exploded myself by accident. Thank you. Right now I'm only interested in doing things that can increase my health, not reduce it. That was a bad call. I got greedy. I wish it was perfect. It's okay, I should be able to get the health I got back. Just keep killing stuff and not take damage. It's the climbing aspects that are dangerous. I guess I have no choice but to go up now. Like, it's easy to go up. Timing. Ah, oh, piss off. There's more. At this point, this is like a sunken cost fallacy. I'm still in a better position, but I should have left when I had the 400 health. But now I'm in a point where it's like easier to go to the top and teleport out than it is to come back down. I kind of got no choice. Had an on hit. Still had a projectile in the air. I have a chance to redeem here. Redemption. Fully heal and then just make up for all the mess that I just caused. It's not look. I mean. As long as I get close. Alright. Perfect. Nope, and nope. Okay. I've got my health back. Now all I have to do is just... Oh, damn it, I thought that was the way forward. It's okay. Just climb and make it. Don't care about the chest, just... I think this is still fine. It's better than 32 health. Okay, I made it. And I got armor for my efforts. Okay. I have a fair shot at doing this now. Jeez. Oh, this arena sucks. want. No. No, get away. As long as I keep aiming well with this weapon, I'll win. Boom. One. Yes! Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Progress. It is progress. The dragon has been freed. Up for a thumbnail. Let's just make it easier on me. Child, you have honor. Tubal, the one you seek lies within me. Many cycles ago, the noise above grew loud. I worked to find him here, bound by other men, presented as a sacrifice. I accepted this offering, but Tubal would not submit. He continued to live, poisoning me from within. Confront him if you wish, but he is Tubal no longer. His mind was consumed long ago, though not by me. Oh my god. I got healed. Excuse me, fire? They're shielded. Whoa, that was lucky. Again. How many forms does he have? Holy shit, first try. First try. That was satisfying. Too many cycles have I lain restless. You have brought me great comfort. My gratitude is given. My energy eludes me. I must rest. I can't believe I just did that first try, dude. So, now what? The Garden of Eden risk level question mark. I should be concerned. How's this guy? Welcome to the Garden of Eden, traveler. A little slice of purgatory. I've been following you closely on your journey. You are not the only one who can read memories with the power of Aesop's tome. and I've been reading yours. After every hard-won battle against an estuary, you left behind a fragment of your past, but every memory dropped was of a different life. Now, I now realize you are the bearer of Hestia's reliquary, the fabled heirloom that transcends life and death itself. Those bound to it inherit the soul and wisdom of every previous vessel, and in your memories I saw the very soul to ever be bound to it. That is of the king's brother, Adel. Now I know why the king sent you to retrieve the fruit. You are the last of his legacy, and the only one he trusts. The fruit is yours for the taking if you can defeat me, but you know that I have already suffused it with black root poison. The poison won't kill the king, but it will weaken him greatly. The king must be stopped. Even now, we can hear the war drums above, and it is clear his invasion will not end until he has claimed the entire world. His very existence is perverse and unnatural. He retains his vitality by stealing the souls of people, and has interrupted the growth of the Tree of Life itself, all to feed his avarice. He is not like you, Abel. You save the lives of others, while he profits from their death. So I ask you, Abel, what will you do? Will you give the poison fruit to your king, or warn him of the truth? Keep the answer to yourself. Words carry lies. I will extract your memories in combat and determine the truth. For king and country, let this battle show me who you truly are. The Master of Swords, Joiner. This is not going to be easy. I won't be able to win how I won before. This feels like a Mega Man fight. Shit. But see, some of this stuff I just won't know what it is until I've died to him once, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is. That's where I can probably take the most advantage. Yeah, okay. No chance. Probably need more upgrades, but... Alright. This was... goes without saying, a good run. Jeez, look at all those enemies. I made meaningful progress. Karen's Scythe. First strike skill crits high health enemies. Second strike crits low health enemies. Weapon. Okay. I guess. I'll take it for the extra gold. I got the feeling I'm gonna have to do grinding. Okay, first, let's just see. You can buy Crescent Chest, okay. So we've pretty much almost got the Crescent set. Oh no, this weapon has its downside. Maybe in the final fight, this would be useful. I don't know. Any new runes to purchase? Actually do something? No. Alright, I'm gonna spend the rest on upgrades. Reroll relics. Armor. Oh, see, there's only one rune weight capacity. It doesn't go any further. Hang on. Oh, there is. There we go. Okay. Yes. This is probably the most meaningful upgrade I can make right now. That should do. I'm gonna make the int on par with this, so it's at 6. I guess I'll unlock a new class. Create black holes, become a comet, absorb the pain of others, convert it into magical energy. No. Okay, more intelligence up. Infinite knowledge. I mean, I just want to see. Purchase infinite knowledge in the soul shop. I haven't done much of the soul shop. That's it. I got 642 gold. I just want to say something now. So I haven't done this in a while. Oh, it's this thing. It's a skill shot. Just curious. A simple start. Sure. Okay. There we go. High level runes can be found. So there's like a bunch of stuff that I should have. It's probably a good call. So, I mean, this game, you can play it for as long as you want. I mean, at a certain point, I will get strong enough. I feel like I need to play more of this mode. But, yeah, I'm at a critical point in the story now. Alright, well, that'll do it for Rogue Legacy. It's been like 4 hours. So, I'm gonna leave it here for Rogue Legacy. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking and sticking around to the end. Hope you enjoyed, and consider button clicking for the algorithm stuff if you want to support the channel, or maybe 2 other videos have popped up and you want to see me play something else. Till next time, bye YouTube.